Born in London in 86, a stature gent named Richard Parliament. He loves to wrestle, but he loves one more thing, and bells round the world. He fights in his comments and he argues with fans. It's a problem no one understands. There's two things he loves, it's getting and bells round the world. Drinking fine wine, fighting fanboys, handhelds round the world.
Top Hat Gaming Man.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Big Daddy Top Hat here, welcoming you to an exciting episode of Handhelds Around the World. In today's video, I find myself in the Great Market Hall, located in Budapest. This impressive building that was built back in 1897 is the largest and most beautiful of its kind in the city. So, with three fantastic floors of fruit, vegetables, dairy products, salamis, fresh fish and souvenirs, what is there that is better to do in here than enjoy some good old handheld gaming? On this trip, I believe I probably made history by becoming the first man ever to play the game child in this fantastic location. This is certainly a historic event for the fine people of Hungary. The game child is an iconic piece of hardware and an extremely influential system. Whilst on the surface it may look like a cheap Game Boy clone with a comedic name that looks like it could have come straight from a comic strip, in reality the Game Child mirrors the very onions you could find in this marketplace, in that its history is layered and it tastes damn great. At first glance, as you can see, the system could easily be a Game Boy, but upon further inspection you will quickly notice that this device only has one action button as opposed to the Game Boy's two, as that is all the might the Game Child needs. To separate aesthetics further, the Game Child has a further four smaller buttons just below the screen, including an on, off and pause button, all amongst them, delivering users a whole range of fantastic options. Where you would place a cartridge though in the original Game Boy, instead one AA battery fits in the Game Child. And if you take off the cover of the Game Child where the batteries are located on the Game Boy, you just get an amusing concealed compartment, with no further use other than to keep your naughty substances in whilst passing through customs, which are usually useful when it comes to getting the best out of this system. Sadly, the lack of a cartridge slot means that each game child is only capable of playing one preloaded game, but I guess that doesn't really matter, as like they say, quality is more important than quantity. And whilst on the exterior the Game Child may look like a Game Boy, in reality it's closer to the classic Tiger Electronic handhelds, offering equally good gameplay experiences too. When it comes to this legendary system, there are actually 6 different Game Child games, but in order to play each one you actually need to buy 6 separate Game Child units to experience each of these exotic pleasures. The Game Child's exciting games include innovative titles such as Ice Hockey, Football, Ghost Hunter, Space War, Desert War and City Fighter. But all of these games would be too mind-blowing to show off in today's video. You all need more time to prepare your souls for an incident like that. What I personally find alluring about the Game Child is the system's legendary attempt to take on the Game Boy and take a slice of Nintendo's success for itself. A great effort was made to make this platform look as Game Boy-like as possible, a handheld in my opinion that is still one of the most iconic to this very day. The Game Child, with its literally legendary form factor, was a fantastic effort in creating a system that allowed parents to buy their children a device that looked just like a Game Boy without having to pay Nintendo prices. The Game Boy was designed to be a budget handheld in the first place, but the Game Child managed to top the Game Boy in every way when it comes to the release of a budget system. Other cheap systems often allowed for cheap interchangeable cartridges, like the Supervision or the Mega Duck. The Game Child, on the other hand, was even cheaper, and due to its built-in game nature, greedy children would not have the ability to nag their over-generous parents for more games on the device. The Game Child was the ultimate all-in-one system. When it comes to locating information online regarding the launch of this system, the device is so mythical there is little info out there to even put forward, as apart from what I've already told you, not much is known about this fabled piece of hardware. Despite all of this though, the allure of such a platform did not stop fellow British YouTuber Ashens from releasing an entire feature-length film focused around this almost unbelievably cool system. The movie focused around his search for this platform, and it was so successful that a sequel Ashen's movie is set to come out at some point soon, as the power of the Game Child knows no bounds. But without further ado, I feel like I have said my piece on the system. So now it is time to pass you over to Planet Earth's leading authority on the hardware. The man in his own words describes himself as a comedy bloke, an acting chap, a review fella, book gent, script dude, and YouTube vermin. It's Stuart Bloody Ashens. Yeah!
So you want to know about Game Childs, or Game Children, or whatever the multiple may be. Well, be honest, I don't think there's a whole lot to know. Not much is known about them, but I don't think there's much to the story other than, around about 1990, manufacturers of cheap toys looked at the success of Nintendo's Game Boy and thought, how can we cash in on that? And the obvious answer was to take the cheapest guts they could find. Old LCD games, which have been around since year dot, as well you know, and stick them in something that looks like a Game Boy shell. That's it, really. And hopefully confuse a few grandmas into buying one of these cheap items for Christmas and appeasing the children. And, of course, that did happen, although the children weren't appeased. That bit didn't happen. Just the grannies buying it bit did. I always liked the Game Child. A, for it's how brazen a rip-off it is. But also, B, I love the name of it. It has that kind of weird... It sounds like a MacGuffin from a movie, doesn't it? The Game Child. Like The Golden Child, that old Eddie Murphy film. In fact, that's why we end up literally making a movie where it's the MacGuffin. Because that's the kind of thing we do. Anyway, this was not the end. This was not the only Game Child produced. The company Maxim just bought a load of them. I was going to say produced them. I'm sure they just bought a job lot and then stuck their logo on it. I've not seen any of the boxes the Maxim ones come in, but I presume it differs slightly from the standard. The standard box, by the way, there were two. There is a bright purpley one, which is, I believe is the one Mr. Top Hat has, and there's also a slightly more Nintendo-looking sort of grey one with yellow writing and a bit of sort of early 90s patterning behind it, which I do have, but annoyingly is in my office, which I cannot reach at the moment due to viruses. However, I can show you a very similarly designed box for the Game Child Mark II! New version. Yeah, because the original wasn't bad enough. So the idea here was that you could play 6-in-1 games, interchangeable, you know, like a real console, except not really. Also, it only actually came with 3 games, so I don't know where you were supposed to buy the others from. They didn't sell them separately, so you'd have to buy, like, a different Game Child and hope the chap on the dodgy market you were buying it from had 2 different versions. There's also a Series 2, unbelievably. I don't know who really got into that. But if you want to see a Game Child Mark II, looks like that. Don't know why the one here is red. I've only ever seen yellow in the flesh. Takes annoying button batteries. And yeah, you can spit the mighty screen out and put in another game, which has pretty much identical game logic and slightly different graphics. And of course, as with all of these things, the contacts never quite work correctly, so you spend ages trying to line them up so you can play the appalling version of volleyball, basketball, or UFO. Sadly, not the Julian Gollop Enemy Unknown version. So that's the Game Child Mark II, but it didn't end there, friends. Oh no. Game Kid, it's slightly smaller. This is where they start putting really catchy names in them, like QGH78 there. Nice. Very similar games, you'll notice, but which I mean pretty much exactly the same. This one bought in Greece by the looks of it. And there's an interesting thing to these. So it's a much more compact version of the old Game Child design there. And just with the left and right buttons, there's no firing on these ones. Look. The games are interchangeable, exactly like the Game Child Mark II. Different size and shape, obviously. But the weird thing is, it only came packaged with one, and doesn't even advertise it as having interchangeable games. So you couldn't buy the game separately or anything. If you wanted a game to exchange for that one, you had to buy a whole new unit, thus rendering the concept obsolete. So I don't really know what happened there. Idiocy, I'm going to presume. And it didn't end there. Then you've got Giant Dinosaur, which, I mean, frankly, they've just taken something very, very similar to the design here, and stuck a dinosaur picture on it because kids like the dinosaurs. Then we went into Dinosaur Battle because apparently dinosaurs were the way these things were going. Don't quite understand that one, but the portrait screen is interesting. And there we are. That is most of your Game Childs and the associated spin-offs. But yeah, as for where they came from, no man may ever know. It's obvious, isn't it? It came from a manufacturer who saw a very, very cheap way to cash in on the popularity of somebody else's product. A tale as old as time. But of course, No Nintendo product was ever ripped off ever again. Oh no, I told a lie.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed joining us for this very special episode of Handhelds Around the World. I would like to give a huge thanks to Stuart Ashens for lending his expertise when tackling such an important subject within our gaming culture. My personal quest for the Holy Grail is now over, as I am a proud owner of this awesome footnote in gaming history. There is nothing quite like the magic of the Game Child. If you're fairly new here, I have a whole backlog of content covering strange devices, including videos on both the Waltara Supervision and the Megaduck, if you would like to check either of those out. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and why not share some memories down below which you have when it comes to playing obscure budget handhelds. Do you own anything as cool as the Game Child? Videos like this are possible in part due to the fine people who back this channel over on Patreon. All patrons get early access to all content, can gain access to my Discord, and get their names in the credits and much, much more. Huge shoutouts and thank yous go out to Sebastian Velez, Carl Johnson, A Murder of Crows, A.O. Paulo Lopez, Joseph Rasmek, Doug Perkins, BXL Gotham, Normal Guy, Rowan Dinched, Evan Border, Philip Manth, Camber Rambo 82, Azra Rarakai, Keith Ferguson, Dropgrim Varela, Prince Knight, Michael Cullix, Ego, Jordan Durant, TOG Driver, Angel I 35, Alephia Swanson, Timothy W. Haskins II, Nick Daniels, Princess Zana, Carlos Domingos, SpongeMap B, Glenny Glenn, Daniel Daly, Computer Man, House of a Ted, Gary Pinkett, ECU Professor, Aaron McNamara, Instant Gratification Monkey, Man Shovel, James Bishop, JB, Posty XL, Michael Hall, Bubba Kitty, Ron Studd, Uti McBoob, Langston Miller, Noob, Casey Wright, Zai, Brian Barry, Chris Margarine, Stephen Lewis, Sarah Powell, Vlaming Renee, Sarai H. Al Sarai, Marvin Araliga, Chris Cool, Adrian Hannington, Bernard NG, Marco Soto, Richard Stu Stewart, Jason McDonald, Crazy Yarl, Hans Christian, Time Lord Soundwave, Dan Van Darn, Adam Kastin, Gregory Smoragiewicz, Rick67, US Fiant, John Bates, David Bow, Angry Little SOB, Mike Bruno, Chris Fisk, Ivan M, Paul Elliott, Mean Machine Dean, Antonio Rodriguez, Craig Jenkins, Tom Elliott, Retroverse.com, Synth Spaces, and Andrew Bozanski. Thank you, all of you, so much for making my job just that little bit easier. I hope to entertain all of you for a long time to come. Yeah. Cheerio.